true what it is. Yes. And he just don't sugarcoat it or nothing. Amen. He just lay it straight on the line like it is. And when I hear him on the radio, the same thing that he be telling, the same way he be telling millions of people, amen. Thank you, praise God. And I'm now going to call Brother Amber Bakia to give us the word tonight.
Praises and grave to our ancestors who, through their suffering and diligence, made all this possible. I want to ask at this time, I'm going to ask you to bow, I'm going to ask you to look up. Will you look up? See, a long time ago, slave man said, you're looking down, close your eyes. Still all the cotton and everything else, you're woken up with nothing there. The book says, watch and pray. Is that right? That's what the book says. Watch and pray. You can't close and watch. So I want to ask you to look up because all from good gifts come above. Oh, gracious mighty creator, we come before you tonight as an humble servant, as an humble black man, seeking guidance to our ancestors who wish to serve you throughout the country, who struggled to try to establish a style, a pattern of life to help us be better people, to understand, to love one another. We ask you to come in tonight and sit among us and guide us. Let us not boast in self, but boast in spirituality and growth, that we may be what you have us to be. And though they cannot, let them be able to have a fertile mind to receive, Lord. Let us be humble and temperate in our giving, that we be able to draw those through love and kindness. And as you go to this time and stand by us and govern our mouths and govern our words as we stand forward to bring forth words of life and encouragement. Thank you, Almighty Creator. You may be seated. And I greet you in the words of our native tongue, the Baragani, Lakutukudila Shaka, Matua Suri, Umani Uzi Shagali. Now just what did that man say? Peace and blessings from the Almighty Creator. You beautiful people, and we shall win without a doubt. Is that right? How many of y'all are winners tonight? Come on. I know this is about first fruits. This is an African celebration, and you should be sad. There ain't no funeral.
Amen.
Come on. No. There ain't no funeral. This is about life and living. Hello, somebody. Hello.
Amen.
Hello, and we want to pray for those that can't seem to do it. Now, if you'll permit me tonight, can I put off my coach?
Right.
All right. Just a little while. At a rapid pace tonight. I'm going to see all this is what this here preacher ought to wear. I tried to appease the people.
Yeah.
You know, I said, come my coveralls.
And go to work.
If you allow me tonight, who knows what happened on December the 7th? Thank you, Pearl Harbor. December 7th, 1941, is that right? Well, do you not know, right down the road, about 94 miles, we had a black hero.
That's right. All right.
How many of y'all knew who he was? Let me see your hand. They knew who the black brother was that come out that day and practically saved Pearl Harbor. You don't know?
All right.
How about Dory Miller?
Yeah.
The cook.
Yeah, he was a cook.
He was a cook in the mess hall. When the Imperial Japanese Air Force came in, began to bomb Pearl Harbor, this black man quit, never fired a gun a day in his life and said, look, I fired. Grabbed his submachine gun, went on top of the mess hall and shot down 3 enemy aircrafts. That's a nigga. Now, that's what we'll find in DISD. No. But right down the road, Mr. Miller, black man, cook in the mess hall on December 7th, put his life on the line. Men were rugging and dugging, trying to find where this man was on top of the building, out open, and was able to bring down 3 enemy aircraft. They later wanted to call us because he wasn't trained in weaponry, but they finally gave him a medal because that wouldn't work. Ain't it funny if you try to do right, brother, they want to try to court martial, y'all's always going to try to do something to you?
Yeah.
White folk cannot stand to be outdone.
All right.
Now, I've been labeled a racist.
All right, me too.
Well, I guess I am, but I studied the racist. But I'm not a bigot, I'm not pretty, but I just love myself.
Amen.
And it's time now that we as African American people learn to celebrate each other.
Yeah.
And one another.
Amen.
I mean, you go around 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, and a kid got to work on 24/7, and you celebrate the white folks.
Yeah.
And they do it to you on a day that they still right. Now, I used to wear black. Y'all used to wear black, but I used to wear African-American. Because to wear black is not depicting people, race, or culture. It's just blacks. You know?
Yeah.
All right? Now, I'm not going to be so much in all that tonight, but I'm going to deal with something else that I answered was heavy into, and that was life.
All right.
What did I say?
Life.
The ancestors was heavy into life.
Yes.
White folks heavy into death.
Yes.
All right.
You didn't get that. You missed me in your mind. Woo! If you look at most Anglos or any other people, they always talk about dying and going to the great beyond. But we as African people did not believe in a death. We go into an underworld, you stand for the ancestors, you'd be judged by the ancestors, and your heart would weigh on a feather, and if it did come up, it'd bring back through you again until your heart got balanced. So tonight I want to talk to you all about life and living. One thing that we as African American people have a problem with, we worry about dying. Let it soak in. No, I don't. Yeah, you do. You were, and rightly so, because it was pushed off on you by slave masters, off on your ancestors, and they was into the dying, because they were told if you died with them, got your long white robe, your golden slippers, and you got to walk, you know, and no more dying, no more crying. You were looking forward to that. But at the same time, while he trying to get you into the death thing, he was fighting to live. Is that right? I want you to get your Bible, that big room, if you will, and I won't take too long, because I know you got things you want to do. And Brother Dacey, I'm glad I made it too.
Amen.
I'm glad to be here.
Yeah.
If you get your Bibles, now the Bible itself is a history book of you African people.
Uh-huh.
To prove my point, the very first country it talks about is Africa in Genesis.
All right.
It don't talk about Asia. It talks about Africa, the very first country. And if Africa being the greatest civilization, that's Ethiopia, the Holy Land. What did I say? It ain't Jerusalem. Huh? Ethiopia is the Holy Land.
Alright.
That's hard to believe, ain't it? Well, if it wasn't holy, why did God go there and put his first man eastward of Ethiopia?
Alright.
Huh? Why did God go all the work there in Africa?
Come on.
Huh? So that tells me that we've been lied to some more.
Yes.
They got you believing you need to go to Jerusalem and walk in the footsteps of Jesus and go where they buried him and all these things and go right ahead on. Spend all your money and go wherever you want to, by that way, but you ain't gonna find no footsteps.
All right.
You can walk anywhere you want to,
all
and you ain't gonna find no tomb where they lead it. Because it ain't that.
Come on.
It ain't that. But I'm gonna talk to you tonight, and I also wanna give you some dates to deal with. Let's talk about life and living. How many of y'all wants to live tonight? Let me see y'all wanna live. How many of y'all wanna live? How many of y'all tired and ready to die? Somebody's got their hand. Hey, put the hand down. You don't want to die, son. That's right, Kenya. You fight to live. Everything wants to live. Is that right? Even a gnat. And building in everything God has built in everything, a mechanism of defense. Hello.
That's right.
Even an ant, you get too close, he wants to know he's there.
Yes.
Huh? Right. We as African American people, we enter the mold of wanting to die because I guess you don't want to suffer. You said, I'm tired and I want to get to, so I want to die. That's not what it's all about. It's about living.
Come on.
Ecclesiastes, the 7th chapter, I believe verse 17, and Luke 20, 36. We as African American people, after many generations of being over here and being oppressed, and Brother Dave said, disenfranchised, be Africanized, all these things, have lost the desire to really live.
Come on.
Some folks just exist from day to day. But to live, go beyond just existing day to day. We have to also learn that the universe exists because we exist. Because the universe is an extension of us. Our children are an extension of us. Y'all still with me?
Yeah.
All right. Why should I talk about living? Because the Creator was about living.
Yes.
He's not about death. See, death came as a result of his obedience.
Oh.
Anytime you disobey, you bring on death in one form or another.
Yes.
Huh? And what happened to us as African American people, when we were brought out of Africa and lost our connection, we began to get into a death mode. We're in a self-destruct mode. soul, we're killing ourselves, and we allow others to kill us. We're the most defenseless people in the world. We'll take anything on. We'll accept anything. Hello. See, it's more than one way of dying. We die spiritually, we die culturally, so we die physically, so. Hello. One thing that Dr. Malcolm said in his lifetime, he says it's a crying shame to see black men stand by and see white men beat black women in the streets.
Yes.
And put dogs on them. We didn't defend our black women. So we died, we lost respect for our women, and we lost the out there. So we lost again. What is death? Death is a non-movement when you get to a decayed mode, and we're in a decayed mode, y'all. We are dying because we're rapidly killing off ourselves. If it ain't drugs, it's us. If it ain't us, it's somebody that's helping get rid of us. We're the guinea pigs for the world. A few years ago, they went and put sitting all the black folks down in Tuskegee for sisters and brothers.
Yeah.
Hello? Tuskegee, hunting experiment. The government did it. And they're still doing things to us. Hello, y'all.
Yeah.
Huh? Why don't you want to live? And everything you look at nowadays is in a death mode. In a death mode. Mm-hmm. You do better when you die. That's not so. Someone read for us. Ecclesiastes. 7th chapter and the 17th verse. Now y'all know me. When I come, I ask you to get in the book and just read. So y'all think I've been made this up. That was ladies, you got it. Okay, mom, come on. You up. Come on. Y'all looking good tonight celebrating your sin. All right.
7:17.
Uh-huh.
Be not over much wicked. Yeah. Neither be thy foolish.
Uh-huh.
Why shouldest thou die before? Why shouldest thou die before thy time?
Let's take a close gander at this. This from the book. Huh? He wants you to say, brother, be not overmuch wicked.
Uh-huh.
Neither be thou foolish. Yeah. And we have become a foolish bunch of people.
Yeah.
Huh? We have become wicked in our own imagination, and we have become foolish in our existence.
Yes.
See, it's a foolish man don't want to think about his history. What happened to us is that we suffer. Three things. Y'all ain't with me. Y'all doing everything with me.
Come on.
Huh?
Come on.
One thing is called low self-esteem.
Oh, yeah.
Huh? Self-awareness and self-efficacy.
Yeah.
We don't know our worth, our value, anything. So what would we run around doing foolish things to each other and others because we don't understand one another?
Amen.
Tell us somebody. Everybody's on the outside and tells us how we ought to act. But we never take time out to define for ourselves how I should act, what I should do, what's right and what's wrong.
All
right. We'll always wait on the master.
Come on.
And I don't mean the Lord either.
All right.
I don't mean the creator.
Yeah.
But see, as my mentor said, Dr. Barry Sanger says, black people ought to stop serving white folks and start serving God.
All right.
Hello. Whatever that white man tells you, you homeless people find yourself, and that's bad.
All right.
That's bad. He ain't gonna say all about your bad and your work. But it says, be not overmuch wicked, neither be thou foolish. Mm-hmm. Why should thou die before thy time?
Mm-hmm.
Which tells me that I have a choice in the matter.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
All right.
But now you don't know that you have a choice in the matter. Do you not know that there right now in Africa, people live here hundreds and hundreds of years old?
Yeah,
know why? Because they got a certain diet, a certain mentality that they operate by.
Come on.
Many of you tonight, we have to go in. Let me slow down. I got excited.
All right, go
ahead.
Right.
Like you said, see, I'm about living.
Yeah.
And if I believe in Jesus,
yeah,
or in the Christ,
yeah,
knowledge, it was about life and not about death.
That's right, brother.
Huh? There are ancestors in Africa right today that live hundreds of years old because they got the proper mind,
yeah,
and a proper diet.
That's right.
Huh? Hello. They found, I have a book at the house, they found a couple of years ago in the Malay in the mountains, they found a man, a Buddhist monk priest. He was 1,000 years old.
My goodness.
He outlived Methuselah. Huh? He was 969 apartment. They said they found this man in the hills,
yeah,
eating vegetables and nuts and praying, and he drank a lot of water. The man was 1,000 years old.
Right.
You sang a song. His eyes is on the road. And I knew he watches over me.
All right.
If he can sit the spell, what about you?
All right.
Soul's not, but he can be soul's not.
Yeah.
What I'm saying, that if God wants something about you, then why are you dying like fools? When God's about life. It tells me that somewhere along the line, we have forgotten the universal law that God has set down for life and living. Jesus came as a prophet to bring us back to the awareness.
Yeah.
See, y'all got excited when he said, and she's going to die for our sin.
All right.
That's where he came from.
Come on.
The book says he's going to save us from our sins.
Come on,
not die for it.
Come on.
Y'all got it mixed up.
All right.
Come on.
Check the book. And she shall bring forth a quote-unquote son. And he what? Shall what? Shall save his people from their sins. There's nobody dying for it. The commentator wrote that in there. Hello. Die for what sin? The sin of ignorance.
Come on.
One of our moral sins, we have forgotten the moral, the universal laws of love, knowledge, and hell.
Come on. All right.
And we're dying because we lost this knowledge.
Yeah.
So why die before your time? You got a choice in the matter.
Yeah.
Proverbs 23:7 says, as a man thinketh, so is he. And we sit around and let folks dump this guilt thing off on us.
Yeah.
Now, honey, you've got to die. Well, if I got to die, then leave me alone. What's wrong? It's the lifestyle. That's it. You so, that's your sister low self-esteem that you take anything to get high.
All right.
Because you feel so bad. Huh? And you're not aware of yourself, so you believe anything that I tell you.
All right.
And then you're scared to trust one another. Huh? I'm so sick and tired of hearing so cliche, black folks just can't work together, huh? Oh, I don't trust them. But if a white man beats you on a daily basis, and tell you, call you nigga, and you still keep going back.
You know what's hard? All of you.
If the cookie is back at the milk, kiss mama and leave some toys.
All right, now. Come on.
If he come in my house and kiss mama, he ain't going out the door.
All right.
And why? He's showing trouble. What do you say? When we allow ourselves to die country so, we have destroyed ourselves. Even your children don't want to be black. Because you don't want to be black. Huh? They grow up with white pictures around them.
Yeah.
Huh? Play with white dolls. Playing pampers with a white baby on the pamper box.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't saying nothing. Huh? And we buy more pampers than anybody in the world. We buy the pampers on the babies now. Come on, talk to me. Y'all make sense? Sure, I'll make sense.
Amen.
Huh? We cry about what we don't have. Yet we spent $3.9 billion last year on junk. On church. Our churches is one of the biggest in the country. Huh? $102 billion last year.
Yeah.
Grossed. Yet we don't own no factories. Huh? Don't own nothing. But a bunch of blameless to me.
Yeah.
Let me see a bishop show.
Huh.
Hey, pastor. Four churches. I haven't gotten past in one.
Hey.
I go past the four. Living in New York, and I pastor in Philadelphia, and I got one down in Florida. Well, that's a lot of flying. You wasn't talking to him.
Yeah, really. No, he got
everything. So why die before your time? We have literally destroyed ourselves trying to be like somebody else. We deny our culture and our own religion for somebody else. Trying to imitate somebody else.
Yeah.
Because he was told that to be black was to be evil.
Yeah.
That your kinky hair was ugly.
Yeah.
But yet your Bible said he had hair like lion wool. But you don't want that.
All right. Come on now.
You don't want that.
Yeah.
Somebody ain't here tonight.
All right. Come on now.
But I want to be like Jesus. Quit lying. Because he was black. In your book,
yeah.
Lady called me and she said, Brother Ham, look here. I heard you say that Jesus was black. Can you prove it? I said, it's in your book, honey. Let's read it.
Amen.
I said, Daniel. Huh? Uh-huh. 10th chapter, verse 4 and 5.
Yeah.
Get it, baby. Revelation, chapter 1 says, the revelation of Jesus, what it said. What do you mean? The revealing of Jesus, what it's talking about.
Yes,
it told what it looked like.
Yeah.
But you guys still buying them white balls, hang on your wall and buying them down. Keep on buying them. God's gonna kick you. Keep on.
All right.
And you're dying because God's gonna kick you. You're lying on
it. All right.
And then you have the nerve to go out. This time of the year, you call it Christmas. And say it's the Lord's birthday. Go out there propagating lies. Buying all these Christmas toys. And trees and fat Santa Claus.
Fat Santa Claus.
Y'all know what I'm saying?
Come on.
Huh?
That's
it. Little Roy Pony fella. No wonder he's fat. You can hear about the house. Go down chimney.
Come out black.
Now, Bible, check this out. Don't get no dust, no soot.
All right.
The homeboy go out the way he came in. Up the chimney. Now, wait a minute. But the Lord is knocking. You ain't let him in the front door. Ain't that bad? That's bad news.
Tell
it, huh? The Lord is knocking. The whole house in the door, I'm knocking. You ain't let me in. Well, it's time to come on down through the chimney, boy. Break the enemy. We got to work toward building a greater inner person.
Yeah.
Come on. We must put off this old negativeness about ourselves. And put on a positive mind about ourselves.
Yeah.
Huh? I quote again, Proverbs 23:7, so is a man thinking, so is he.
Yeah.
And we gotta quit thinking bad about ourselves,
yeah.
Because when I think bad about me, I sure don't like you.
All right.
Yeah.
Why? Because you look like me.
All right.
And if I hate you, I sure hate you.
All right.
And I have a habit of laying my fault on you because you look like me. See, if you were me, I could do better. That's the same scheme that Adam shot off on Eve when the Lord called him a question about what happened.
All right.
He didn't call his that woman you gave me.
Yeah.
All right.
Ain't my fault, your fault, you gave it to me.
All right.
I'm all about, man, take it out. Wait, you know, I'm not the fault, you gave it to me. She did it.
All right.
That's how the light goes on. In the book called Took Back Civilization, we finance our own oppression. I'm so sick and tired of you kids breaking my heart. I ain't gonna die though. Huh? I told you once, I told you twice, I'm telling you again. When you go out there and buy those suits, it says true. And those tennis says true. They are owned by the Ku Klux Klan, knucklehead. They're buying guns with your behind with your money.
That's right.
Something else, y'all know that Japan making a lot of African artifacts. Japan's making them for you.
Yes,
these here, they make it because they know. Come on, it's big bucks here because they're trying to find themselves. But they know who Ho Chi Minh is.
Yes.
They know, huh? Who Confucius is.
That's right.
Huh?
Black.
And we're the only folks that go in our restaurant. You can't buy nobody's in the restaurant at all. But I tell you, go to a Mexican restaurant, what you gonna find? Go to a Chinese, what you gonna find? Huh? Go to a Black, what you gonna find? God knows what. In a lot of time, Elijah Muhammad, peace be upon him, he said, you can see a white man walking down the road with a bag with a baby in a bag. You tell us a white baby, man. So you see a Mexican, see a Mexican, a Mexican baby. But see what else, you better take it out, you know what's in the basket. We're the only place that anybody walk in and marry our women. Don't say nothing about it. We're making fuss. Huh? We're aiding our own what? Structure. We talk about black men marrying white men, but how about you black women marrying white men?
Alright.
Huh? Because 70% of our women do wind up dating white men. It's disgraceful. And then I look around, I see the white slave in our community one more again. This white thing called crack.
Amen.
Huh? It's making whores out of our daughters. Pimps out of our sons. And not only that, it's making homosexuals out of them.
Yes.
Yes. And it's how it affects the hormones. You got girls acting like dudes.
Yeah.
Huh? And little boys.
Come on.
I want some bump. Give me a bump. Get you a pump.
Amen.
I'm out there. I see you, and you don't see me. I'm looking at you. Huh? But the crime ain't got preachers dealing
dope.
Quiet down before your time. And there must be a change in attitude. And the only way we're gonna stop this is get a change in self. Romans 12, 1 and 2. Second verse. Be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your foot.
Your mind.
Your Gucci bag.
Your mind.
Your Calvin Klein jeans.
Your mind.
Your Jordache.
Your
BMW. BMW. Just look at it. BMW. Black
man's will.
Man wanting. Because you get one, you'll still be wanting.
That's right.
Black man wanting.
Yeah.
And we think we have really been made it over.
Yeah.
It's not in materialistic things that you made over. We're yet slaved mentally, so.
Right.
We need to go back and get all this money that we spend and begin to create an economical base to save our children. But they are the extension of us. If these babies go, we've had it. And they're the target now. They're the target. They ain't worried about you old folks now. They get me. These. Those little 12 balls that was at Carter. Huh? It was sad. But look what happened to those 12 balls. As soon as the judge gave them sentence, less than 3 days, they were dying in the hospital. And some folks been down there 2 years, they got there yet.
That's right.
Huh? But these 12 black boys, pop one of young black leaders, they were in prison in 3 days after the sentence. I got the news that one of them was raped when he got there. Lost his manhood. Why die before your time? When we allow our children to get out there and do anything, we'll get them to the wolves and eat them up. We're killing our own babies. While we watch as the world turns. A dynasty. And we're just putting tomorrow the guy in life. Young and restless.
Yeah.
All my children.
Uh-huh.
And the general hospital. Young black brother wrote a book, Blacks and Blues. You may have heard about the book. But the boy that was interviewing, I went down and talked to young brother through his mentality. Look, the boy had to be crazy. Had to be crazy. He said that, we ought to quit laying a lot of things on these white folks and so forth and so on. He didn't be in affirmative action. So I asked him how did he get his job. He's 26 years old. It was through affirmative action he got his job. But once a long time ago, a black couldn't get a job like that. When I came out of military service in 1963, with over 280 academy hours, Alan First came to Dallas and applied for the police department. He told me I was overqualified. I applied right here in Dallas to build because I got tired of shooting down my people. They said, you're overqualified. At one time, he had that field house, no college grad to go be on Dallas Police Department. So I couldn't even read and write down there. But soon the black started to get to change the criteria. 45 semester college hours. Hello. What must we do? We must go back and reassess the thing and create our own world in the world.
Right.
Not the Bible though you're in the world, but you're not of this world. It's time to go back, y'all.
Right. Right.
It's time to go back and be our own society and limit our foreign
language.
It's time to go back and have our own education system. We're not being educated anymore. We're miseducated.
Right.
Huh? Go back and get our babies and educate our babies how to respect one another. To my teenage pregnancy. Ain't no big thing. Maryland thinks she had Jesus.
Yeah.
No big thing.
Come on.
But isn't he teaching you how to raise your baby when you get one?
Yeah.
Don't get on grandma.
Come on.
Huh? You get it, you take care of it. You enjoy getting it, take care of it.
Yeah.
I ain't talking back to me. Huh? But I ain't got time to put you down. I gotta help you get off. Cause the idle mind is the devil's workshop. And risk is on the rise again. I'm about our time.
Yes, it is.
$5 for your time. What are you saying? That we need to go back. Huh? Get off your knees, mommy. Pray it up. Get up. Get up, pray it up. Time is action, huh? Get in action. We are praying, begging folks in the world. It ain't got nothing to show. So never get up. Huh? Luke, I'm coming to a close. 20:36. We see that the school has failed us. GISDA is bunking out more black folks.
Come on here.
Huh?
Yes, they are.
What we ought to do is teach them a lesson. Huh?
Teach them a
how
lesson. Come on here.
Just one day don't go to school.
Let's
keep all of them
on. Come on here.
Huh? Because we make up 55% is made for black folks of the school system. Just never stay at home.
Yeah.
Jay Leno know how to stay at home.
Every
time. Huh? And see, you want to find out that when you do that, wife is like, what's the matter? And I tell you one thing else. trying to leave them nowhere.
Uh-huh.
You all spend real money.
That's right.
White folks spend paper.
Sure,
what did I say? They spend paper. They say, well, it's $1 million deal. They write and sign pass. No, ain't no money pass.
Right.
But you pass real dollar bills. Huh?
Yeah.
Y'all pass yourself. Y'all got, huh?
That's right.
Amen.
I tell you what y'all to do. And ICA, where I'm the founder and chairman of, we plan on next year to hit in the pocket.
All right.
We say, everybody, say, where do you make a day? Save that amount of money up. On a certain given day, we all gonna stay home, don't go to work that day.
All right.
If you make $100, they save $100. That day you take off, pay some, take off that day, take your day off.
All right.
And pay some, take off that day. That means you don't lose nothing.
All right.
And sit on downtown screen. Where's the niggas? That's the money. Where's the niggas? Huh? Because we buy the buses, we fill them up.
All right.
Come on. We cook in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't saying if we don't show up, they won't function, y'all. You ain't test out your power.
Pocketbook power.
That's what it says.
Yeah.
Because the book says, in Ecclesiastes 10:19, money is the answer to all things.
Yeah.
So what you do, you start saying, well, I make $100 there. I start saving $10, I get $100.
Uh-huh.
And then, oh, you don't got the king's birthday, or some day that I want to choose, I ain't going to work.
All right.
That's right.
I ain't going to call and tell no lies, and I ain't going.
Uh-huh.
That's right.
I ain't going. Yes. No, I'm not coming there, honey. I'm just not coming.
All right.
Come on here.
It will cause a major breakdown in this system. If y'all don't go to work one day, just one day. You wouldn't work.
All right.
See how it goes. It would have another breakdown.
Right.
It would go gone, man.
Uh-huh.
See, because see, you know the power you have, you test your power.
Yeah.
All these black women drive them buses.
Yeah.
And they didn't show up that day.
All right.
Just one day.
One day.
Huh? Them guys, people flow, didn't show up one day.
All right.
We think it happened in America. White people go pants on black women.
Yeah.
They go crazy.
I know I can go there.
Huh?
All right.
Y'all be a dude. In 1979, all truck guys said, we're going to stop America hard.
Yeah, I remember that.
And I went out letting the pants.
Yeah, I remember that.
Everybody said, let's do a shutdown.
Yeah.
Across the nation, 10 miles an hour. Don't drive, no faster, 10 miles an hour.
Uh-oh.
Jack, we get them down to the low gear and drop the 10, just crept along. They start crying, where's the food? Oh, oh, where, what? Oh, no. We had a major, the jam, a car jam, across the country. 1979, we tired of this country's heartbeat. So you go through truck route, we said, go get y'all business.
All right.
Huh? And we prove it to them. Now you black folks, do the same thing. Oh no, I'm scared of my job. I got to be a Burger King in the morning. Talking about the old guy, don't be there.
Watch out.
If, just say this year. I know y'all got in debt for the Tinker Toys and the Teddy Panthers and the Bobby Dolls and all this stuff and the Nintendo games and all these things. So I know you're in debt the next year. But don't buy them next year. Save all your money, okay, for next year. And come December, don't come October, don't buy nothing. And watch downtown start panicking. Don't go to Blackberry Mall. Don't go to Blackberry Mall. Don't go to North Park. Just stay at home.
Yeah.
Don't spend no money.
All right.
And you see what's going to happen. Even the Jews going to go crazy.
Yes, they will.
Because see, the Jews don't celebrate Christmas.
No.
Huh? They celebrate what they call Yom Kippur.
Yeah.
Huh? Day of dedication.
Yes.
They don't celebrate no Christmas.
That's right.
They know you do, so they put the stuff for you by.
Yeah.
They play on your weakness. Hello, y'all.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
And watch me. When you get through, then they start theirs. Who control the weather world? The Jews do. Why? Because they got a system.
Yeah.
They stole from us. Why? Die toward the time. Don't let them tell you about the Holocaust. Tell them about the Middle Passage.
That's right.
To about 6 million Jews, about 50,000, 50 million black people went down the Middle Passage to battle.
Right. That's right.
That was a Holocaust.
That's right.
Huh? And we don't put stuff off me that. You ain't never done nothing. See, what with me? We have no lights. I ain't been the first light when you put on in your house. What with me? You couldn't even breathe. I ain't been the first gas man.
All right.
The fire that you rise, I put the ladders on it.
All right.
Huh? But you don't know this, you can't. And quit calling by Columbus Day. That's the biggest lie ever been told. He never been discovered on America. The boy had Arthur Rock lying down in South America somewhere, down in the islands. It was the Moors who were black people who the Maryland sent us up.
I get called in a deep meditation with the Lord. He picked me up. I
see me driving the car, but I will be there.
That's right.
He carried me on a journey and he showed me things to talk to me.
All right.
It's called an out-of-body experience. You in tune. Y'all ain't saying nothing.
All right.
Huh? You in tune. He said, you know, I've been here before, but I don't know why, but I've been here.
Yeah.
Because the Lord has already carried me.
Yeah.
All right. Huh? I seen you, and I know, but I can't place my I seen you. Though you're in the world, but you're not of the world.
Come on.
See, you as African people are the chosen generation.
Yes.
You were brought up out of Ethiopia. That's the word Ethiopia comes the word African, which means to see.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't
that's right.
It, huh? Yeah. Huh? Yeah. You go to a world of opportunity for your eyes.
Yeah.
Ethiopia is the Greek word for eyes.
Yeah.
The land of the seals. The prophets was there. But hey, but see, my grandmother said, child said, you know, said, I could tell you've been in the sun.
All right.
I felt it.
Yeah.
Huh?
All right.
You ever been somewhere and you get a strange feeling? And so I said, something wrong. See, that child, is said, you're going to call me. Something, what's about this boy?
All right.
Mama, something. I felt it. Because y'all ain't talking back to me.
All right.
See, you ain't like nobody else. You know, white people don't understand you because you're not like them. You are part God.
Yeah.
You are a God.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You're a king and priest, and you don't know that.
Yeah.
You're creators. Because God made you in his image.
Yeah.
And things get after you. Because you don't know your worth, so you don't know how important you are.
That's true.
And because you don't have no awareness, you gotta be like, you try to find yourself.
Yeah.
You gotta be like this, you gotta be like it. You just do because you lost.
Come on.
Huh? But stop. Steady yourself.
Yeah.
An old man, know thyself.
Know thyself.
Huh?
All right.
Huh? Jesus said, huh? The kingdom of God is within you.
Within you.
Oh, and we'll spend more time on learning about what's in us.
That's right. Yeah.
The book said in 1 John 3 and 9, I'm walking deep now, y'all can
all right.
Walk, huh? Whosoever is born of God doeth not commit sin, but the seed remains in him and it can not. For he is what? Born of God. So if I'm in both, y'all ain't talking
about
that.
All right.
Then I'm in what? I'm God-like in nature.
Yeah.
He said, oh God, he said, why? He said, oh man, huh?
Come on.
Told the Lord, I said, why are thou so mindful of him?
Come on.
That you make us look at Lord and angels.
Yeah.
I'm not Lord. I'm equal with the angels.
All right.
Huh? Y'all ain't saying nothing.
Come on.
Huh? Because he made what? In his image.
Yeah.
In his likeness.
Yeah.
Huh? Which means that I can speak and things happen.
Yeah.
Y'all want to talk back to him?
Man.
Black people, you live in Egypt today. You have a power to control the universe.
Yes.
But you won't talk to the stars.
All right.
But the white people say that's taboo.
Yeah.
Grandma planted her cotton and corn by the stars and all
that.
Y'all ain't saying nothing, huh?
Right.
And the first omelet was created by a black man.
Yeah.
When he brought out the group plan from Washington, D.C. and the Capitol City, he also made the first clock. Y'all ain't talking
all
back
right,
to me.
Right.
And the first bobblehead. That ain't good enough. Uh-huh. Hello, huh?
Come on.
The red light that been by Gary ain't Marley. He got time to run on one another at the corners.
That's right.
Huh? The light bulbs invented by L. Nixon. Huh?
Yeah.
Mr. Lack. Huh? The first telephone wouldn't even work. Took Grandma T. Wood to put it together and make it work right.
Yeah.
What? It wasn't Grandma Bell. Grandma T. Wood.
Yeah.
The baby carriage.
All right.
Ralph Hoffman.
All right.
Huh? The Iron Boys. Sarah Boone.
Yeah.
The first self-made millionaire was Madam C.J. Walker.
Yeah.
Black woman. Y'all ain't talking back to me. Huh?
Yeah.
You did all this. And watch yourself. You are not the copy. You're the real deal.
Richard's
right. Huh? White folks trying to look like you.
Yes, sir.
But they ask you fools that, you gotta look like us. Because they don't be like them, wasn't right. They gotta be like you. Huh? It took them almost 50 years to get someone to dance as close to us. Ever tried this bad thing? He didn't make it. Huh? He couldn't make it. All the black songs he sung, he still couldn't make it.
Yeah.
But now y'all scared me. You should watch the little bandstand just fall out of land.
Yeah.
Y'all don't even see. And now y'all scared me.
All right.
Y'all scared me? Huh? George Michael won a Soul Awards last year. White boy. Y'all know something wrong?
Something wrong.
Huh? They out dancing now. They out singing now. The new kids on the block.
Yeah.
White boy.
White boy.
Mmm.
And I'll tell y'all something. Huh? Took your jazz and called it classical music.
Yeah.
That was your music.
Well.
Huh?
Oh, my.
Huh? Trying to act like you.
Yeah.
Huh?
All right.
You trying to act like them. They were just falling apart. They already fell apart.
Yeah.
Come to a close. What are you going to do, black folks, to save yourself? What are you going to pay for freedom? Be free in your mind, because you're still slave in your mentality.
That's right.
Huh? We're the only folks that ask the white man, can we have a day to celebrate? Can we have Dr. King's birthday to celebrate? Can we? The Japanese came to China and asked them, they celebrate a whole new year.
Yeah.
Huh? The Japanese New Year was a whole year. Ain't had like nothing. Huh? Those immigrants that sneak back in here from across the border, y'all come from Mexicans? Huh? Huh? Take the mile, ain't asking nothing. Take the mile, Jack, and doing it up.
Yeah.
Ain't asking nothing. You ask, can I think I'm celebrating King's birthday? Like you're some kind of child. Gotta ask about mission. Can you? Tell me, you grown? You ain't grown. You should ask Mr. King.
Right.
What we gonna do about our babies? This is the oldest generation been prophesied and said it's gonna read below the grandparents. Can't even read. Say, we got churches that is helping keeping us in the dark.
That's right.
Too afraid that folks hear the lie. Huh? That's too scared. Don't do that. Don't do that. We learn to protect ourselves again. Richland, Texas, up the road, a few days ago, a little black boy was going with a white girl, and they hung him. And hardly 30 miles from where you live. Malone, Texas.
Yeah, that's right.
Right down the streets. They stoned a black boy to death, beat him to death with bricks. Because he was seeing a white woman.
Why don't they do something to the white woman?
No, they don't do that. Because they want y'all to think she's still pure. She's been a dog all the day.
All right.
Fairfield, they killed one in Fairfield, Texas.
Sure.
Same thing. Hung a black boy in Terrell, Texas, and he hung his shelf. He had about 6'2", on hands up on 5'11" nail.
All right.
A few days ago, they strung a strange young man to death with that death hoax. Right here in Dallas. Didn't tell anybody, killed him. In South Dallas, 2 months ago, they shot a little boy down over on Dixon Circle, shot him down in the alley. Nobody didn't much say about it. Couple years ago, they shot down a black woman, an old woman, shot her down her own house. You ain't said nothing about it. Huh? An old man trying to protect the property over there on Edgewood, shot him down like a dog, but he said nothing. Huh? 85% of the Dallas police are card-carrying Ku Klux Klansmen. Y'all ain't said nothing about it. And you're paying them to kill you out. But now, how the fuck at their own police department, at their own mayor, at their own jail,
University
Park? Do you not know that Oak Cliff, used to be called Oak Cliff, Texas?
Yeah,
you have a charter that you can reenact and get your own mayor, your own police department, your own everything back if you wanted it? Huh? All this was in cooperation to get Dallas like it is, but these were all the small towns. Oak Cliff, South Dallas, were little towns around Dallas. It became a part of a charter co-op, made it big as it is today. But you don't know your history, so you don't know where to go back. You don't know that in 1867, black folks burned
ground.
Burn it down to the ground. Because they hung for these black men. And slavery vote, they burnt down, you know? Many didn't know there was a black preacher who people didn't have respect for, named Father Jayvon Brown. Walk against fair party, get nigger, they took down. And you just go there, you want to go out there. Him and him about 10 sisters with white headbands and white clothes on marched around fair party. Get nigger, they took off of fair party. Before they had called Klan Day out there, and 75,000 white folks showed up for Klan Day. Can't go to Fair Park, got no money out there. The lies of the law behind the land was taking the bill, Fair Park, don't nobody do you. The bombers in South Dallas, where they blow up white or black people's homes,
yes.
Run them off, just get the land to build Fair Park.
That's right.
You find it's your own oppression. Why are you telling me this? Because you need to know this.
That's right.
That was yesterday. It's today too, baby.
That's
still,
right.
Still taking your land.
Yes, it is.
Huh? But brother, that we don't forget about that. But you don't forget. Why you don't forget?
Right.
If you forget, history will repeat itself.
That's right.
Race is gonna rise again, baby.
Yes, it is.
Just matter if they go back and put the old water fountain back up, says white folks and black folks.
Yes, they will.
They doing it. They doing it. You go places now and get gas. Can I use the bathroom? We're gonna have one. They lying. They got a lot of things with it all day. Don't use the bathroom, brother. But you can't use it. We gonna be in bad shape if that white man or that tight eyed man. They just moved in.
Uh-huh.
They bought out the white man.
Uh-huh.
Decide we ain't gonna have it from black folks. What do you think would happen, sister? You that pretty hat on, yelling black on back there. Wait, what part of town do you live in this week? We're in the heart of Ku Klux Klan territory. Suppose they would decide that you couldn't go to the store no more. You couldn't buy more groceries. The boy said he couldn't try to cut the water off. Cut the lights off. What you gonna do? I said, what you gonna think about it?
Burn the store down and
move it. I go kill them. Whoa! I'll be mad to fight you. But y'all don't know that they got us right now boxed in. They can take some train on across certain parts of Dallas, train and stop them and cut you off.
That's true.
And you can get no food.
That's true.
See, in Tampa, you ain't even know where to cut the switch on, cut the lights off, put the lights back on. And they cut the water off and everything. You're being total starving.
That's right.
If they ever decide to go and close millions up for us, we're not going to starve to
death.
If they close it up, you're going to starve to death. Why? Because you have lost the technology of how to take care of yourself. We've got a threat of parasites. You know what a parasite is? He feeds on something else other than itself. Huh? We need to go out and get some land. Like the man. Huh? Save our money like tomorrow.
Yes.
Gotta get over before I go under. James Brown said that back in the 60s. We didn't listen to him. Huh? Huh? Build your factories, create your own job.
We should be doing this here.
Yeah.
Yeah, bro, right?
Yeah.
Bro, tell us something.
Come on.
Huh? Try to tell us something. Say it loud and black and proud. Well, we didn't listen, just like y'all today.
That's right.
Y'all got all that rap out there, y'all listening. Y'all ain't listening.
You ain't listening. Yeah.
Listening. Ain't good enough. Y'all hear about AIDS getting vaccinated. Y'all still getting vaccinated. Then AIDS only flow. It's you live with AIDS. That's right. It's a known fact that the federal government is dealing with AIDS virus and vaccinations.
SV40.
Thank you. How many of y'all got vaccinated from watching the show when you was a little kid? gave you a vaccination?
You?
Who? Who's the baby killed during that time? Polio. Thank you.
Good.
Things that long with polio didn't even know it. But thanks to Almighty God above.
Thank you, Lord.
Huh? It wouldn't work.
All right.
Huh? It wouldn't work.
Wouldn't work.
Huh? They tried to kill all the syphilis?
Yes.
Didn't work.
Didn't work.
But guess who got it?
They had.
They put AIDS in the virus. Guess who got it?
They
did. Those say that you did one get you, then you did two. Because the get you did just might be for you.
Huh?
We're coming to a close now. I thank you for your time and your patience. The question once again is, why die before your time? If I get Brother Davis in the choir to help me with a little song that I wrote a couple of years ago, I'm going to sing this. Oh, yeah, I do a little of that, too. Do a little of that, too. I want to invite you out to ICA at 1844 South Boulevard, where we have a cultural school. We have the only school of this type in the history within 2,000 miles to teach you African culture, technical development. We got a plan, y'all, to save ourselves if you come by and listen to us. This brother has a brother student there. Got called 360. We're working on to save ourselves. Huh? I'm gonna ask the choir to come up and help me with this. Come on, it's just a real simple song. Ain't nothing hard. Ain't nothing hard. And young love, you might like it.
Thank you.
get along with the group. They can't cut.
All right.
Well, did you happy tonight?
Yeah.
It work?
Yeah.
They work?
Yeah.
Did y'all enjoy Brother Emerson's kid?
Yeah.
He just tell it like it is. Yeah. He just tell it like it is. Amen. Amen. God, people couldn't deal with it tonight. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. What the Bible said, the truth gonna do what? Jammer,
and that means cooperative economics, to build and maintain our own stores, shops, and other businesses to profit together from them. And that means it's like you going out and getting your own job, so you might not want to go out and go out to what Bloomingdale's, some of these big stores, you know, stores we can go to ourselves and put our money back into our own city or whatever, amongst our own people.
Right.
And the fourth day would be another green candle, and which means Naya, and that means purpose.
Yeah.
To make as our collective vocation and vocation, the building and development of our community in order to restore our people to their traditional greatness.
Yeah.
And the fifth day would this is sixth day, which would be a red. And it's Kaamba, which is creativity. To do always as much as we can in the way that we can in order to leave our community more beautiful and beneficial than when we inherit it. And that means, you know, the land, the city you are, to help to clean up and keep it clean, just like if you have your own house or something, you can like to keep it clean. That means we can go out and keep our own community clean without, every time you go outdoors or whatever, you see the ice cream and you throw your paper right on the ground and stuff, cleaning up your community and keeping it nice and clean. And I think, we should think about, what we do more, it's a function for, we want to keep our community clean. And seven days, we may get the red candle. And we have Amana, meaning
money.
Faith.
Money.
Amani?
Money.
Who, Amani?
Amani. Amani.
Amani.
Amani.
Amani.
Faith. Faith.
Meaning faith. To believe with all our heart and all our parents and teachers, all our leaders, all our people, and the righteousness victory of our struggle. And that would be the seventh day. Again, well, I guess we would combine all this together for the, from all that we've learned from, say, our parents, teachers, all the learning that we've got, we would come together as one, and we would talk about this. And this the seventh spiritual principle of Kwanzaa. And there's start like Kwanzaa's also, it started right after on the 26th day after Christmas, so we don't. Was I moving too fast? I forgot one?
No,
she was telling me that. I'm looking at someone telling me that I forgot one, so I was trying to see which one did I
know. No, you got one.
I thought I did, but is the one that you want to do? And it begins like on the 26th and stops on the 1st, and so those would be the days that you celebrate.
Thank you.
black man.
Yeah.
continue on with the program. We're going to have Sister Bagla, Word Revival Temple, come up here and sing Black Man.
All right. Well, come on, shout Jesus.
Jesus!
Y'all there? Y'all need resurrected? Amen. Yeah. This is a song that I wrote, that God gave to me when I was sitting at the table at home, and I was looking in the encyclopedias, the Sounds Encyclopedia, and we're looking them up about, I think it was in chapter, it was one of them was by Louis S. B. Leakey, and me. And this is, I just need a little beat. I can't rap like them rappers do, but I'm doing my best.
Now I see the storm clouds in your waking eyes. The thunder,
the wonder, and the young surprise. Your every step reveals the new stride in your thighs. From the great Kilimanjaro to the Mother Nile, your resources include coal, limestone, diamonds, tin. They're all mined from the sweat of the brow. Your animals are unlike any found in the world. Earliest man from 1.5 to 2 million years BC believed to have lived in Udawa Gorge, Tanzania.
All right.
Okay, your religion mostly tribal, believing in the Most High God who created the universe and man, sacrifices animals and prayers to expel the evil forces causing misfortune and illness upon the earth. Keeping in the foreground the cultural heritage of the Trinity, Horus, Isis, and Osiris. Your music is multi-rhythmic. The low beating of the tom-toms. The slow beating of the tom-toms. Low, slow, slow, low. Stirs your blood. Dance. A night-veiled girl whirls softly into a circle of light. Whirls softly, slowly, like a wisp of smoke around the fire, and the tom-toms beat, and the tom-toms beat, and the low beating of the tom-toms stirs your blood. The African dance is one of the highly developed African arts. Your education is one of the major goals of most African governments, stressing research as a way to raise productivity, along with combating the shortage of trained teachers, accepting the challenge and producing some of the most noted scholars in our day. Your leaders, Ramses, Shaka, Haile Selassie, Anwar Sadat, and Yakuba Gonar, just to name a few. Your art is unsurpassed, from the pyramids, hieroglyphics, early civilization, to the many artifacts of today. And I'd like to conclude with this poem written by the late Langston Hughes, Afro-American Fragment. So long. So far away is Africa. Not even memories alive, save those that history books create. Beat back into the blood. Beat out of blood with words sad sung. In strange, un-Negro tongue. So far away is Africa. Subdued and time-lost are the drums. And yet through the vast mist of race, there comes this song. I do not understand. This song of activistic land, of bitter yearnings lost without a place. So long, so far away, is Africa's dark face. Y'all pray for me.
Amen. That's what I like about people, because they're still willing to keep on with the program. Go ahead on, amen. Thank God for that spirit, amen. And right now, we're going to kind of change the service a little bit.
Oh.